in it.
I made it.
Barely. And it is now
refill.
Time
Sorry.
For News of the Strange. I've been waiting for this. I'm so excited.
First time doing News of the Strange?
First time, but I watch it all the time, at least later when it's not so early.
That's pretty early. It's still 621. Oh, 622.
Oh, we're cruising right along.
All right.
An elderly couple in Oklahoma have become darlings of the internet. The couple posed for a photo shoot inspired by The Notebook. Clemma and Sterling Elmore are celebrating 57 years of marriage, and the photographer said she immediately thought of The Notebook when she saw them together. And in no one's surprise, the adorable photos are going viral.
Aww.
Definitely adorable.
That's awesome. Congratulations to them.
57 years, quite the feat right there. Definitely something to celebrate.
Wow.
And take a look at this. Officials in Russia are trying to figure out why a Serbian river was suddenly turned bright red. Residents are starting to report the bizarre color of the river on Tuesday. Russia's Ministry of Natural Resources and Environment says the color change could have been caused by leakage from a nearby chemical plant. But
oh, that's nice.
Oh, absolutely bright red. That's insane to look at. But they have yet to confirm. They say the river is not linked to any water supplies, thankfully, but that is bright red.
I was going to say, look for the guy who stole a truck full of food coloring, but...
It looks like definitely when they dye the river's green for St. Patrick's Day, that almost looks fake.
That always kind of weirds me out, too. I figure if they can dye it green once a year, I don't know why they can't dye it blue the other 364.
And the Olympics ended over a month ago, but for some, it's actually just the beginning. The housekeeping Olympics is underway, from bed stripping and bed making to linen folding, laundry stacking, and an obstacle course. Housekeepers are getting the chance to show off their skill, and the goal of the Housekeeping Olympics is to celebrate the work of hotel housekeepers everywhere. This is the 12th year of the Housekeeping Olympics. The celebration will continue into next week for National Housekeeping Week, which is celebrated across the U.S. Now, I have to say, I'm super excited about that. I would take home gold in vacuuming.
Really?
Yes. Oh, my gosh. Awesome vacuum.
Oh, look at that. Wow, she had those towels stacked up.
Part of the competition, you know, you got to compete.
So they're like rowing beds and toilets, and that's crazy.
I'm sure Jake and Sarah will do a story on that later, who the winner was.
Okay, that's good. We're gonna count on that. Of course, weather-wise, things are they're active across the area, especially coming up tomorrow. Big cold front on the way. Definitely want everyone to be aware of that. Today, we're looking 20% chance of rainfall. Now, today, I don't see much in the way of thunderstorm activity. I do think there will be at least isolated storms. Like yesterday, you looked at the radar, and this is probably around, I want to say 6 or 7 o'clock, I looked at the radar, and there were just a couple little cells down near McCamey, and then more out to the east of Big Spring, but they were few and far between. I think today could be a lot like that, but where you do get a thunderstorm, if it ends up over one of our Friday night football games, people are going to know about it. We're going to know about it. People are going to call and yell at me.
That you're bringing the rain.
I'll have bad emails in the morning. But then you go into your Saturday, and we're talking 75 degrees for a high temperature. Your temperature outside right now is just a degree or two below that. So it's similar to your low this morning. Will be your high tomorrow, and we'll have that northeasterly wind. Chance of rain looks very good. We also, of course, we have... a big event going on at the National Weather Service tomorrow from 10 a.m. to 2 p.m. It's an open house at the National Weather Service. And so, you know, we talk about weather. Of course, we forecast the weather here. We give you a weather report. But during periods of severe weather, there's a variety of different people involved. There's the forecasters with the National Weather Service. There's our meteorologists here at the studio, emergency managers, firefighters that are out doing the water rescues, things like that. We're all working together. We're all in one big chat room. We're briefing each other. We're going back and forth. Of course, then I come over and brief you guys in the news department.
It is great to see that teamwork, but really all the behind the scenes work that goes into it that nobody realizes, even some of us in news. So
yeah, if you get a chance, it's at the National Weather Service office tomorrow from 10 to 2. You come out, there's going to be tours of the office out there. Of course, their computers are really cool. They have things out there called AWIP stations. These things are awesome. And if you're interested in weather, you'll really get a kick out of it.
And I know that we told our boss to call about our matching mugs. Our boss didn't call, but Monica, who's watching in Hobbs, I get to brag for a second.
Okay.
I don't fill in on mornings. This is my first morning, but she said that she just thinks you are hilarious. And so Monica from Hobbs, who's watching, I have to agree. So.
Hey, thank you guys. Good morning. And if you were up.
I agree.
You were up at like 4 in the morning then, if you're in Hobbs, because you're an hour behind.
Oh, wow. Okay.
Us here, so. We thought our schedules were bad.
I know. That's wild. Yeah, 4 in the morning, that's a bit much, especially if you're not at work.
That's Carla's BFF.
Oh, that's Carla's BFF.
Our producer Carla in there.
Well, she's up watching. Good morning in Hobbs, New Mexico. Also saw somebody from Houston was watching us on our Facebook feed. So yeah, if you have not done so, you can actually, we are streaming live on the internet. So if you're traveling out of town, but you still want your CBS 7 fix, just go to our website. We're streaming it up right there.
Perfect. All right. And when we come back, we'll have the latest local and national headlines. But first, here is a peek at our iCam over here.
City of Midland. Greg forgot to change the camera. I will change that in just a minute.
It is beautiful over there, though.